Hello, welcome to the Grand Canyon.
Yeah? Okay.
Please join me today for a 10-minute flow, standing flow, no seated. So come on up to standing whenever you're ready. Make sure that your feet are about sits bones or fist distance apart, and that you can find grounding into all four corners of your feet, finding the tripods of your feet, the ball of your foot, the heel of your foot, really rooting down. And then from there, start to feel the energy rise up from your inner shins, inner thighs, lifting up through pelvic floor and creating more of this sort of wrapping feeling happening in the front of the abdominal wall. So this is your pelvic floor. We're moving up into the core, which moves from the hips to your shoulders, and it just wraps around you. So as you inhale, expand that cylinder. As you exhale, draw it inward towards your spine. Inhale to expand from hips to shoulders, that whole core, that whole cylinder. Exhale to shrink in, narrowing. One more. Inhale, expand. Exhale, draw in, feel the earth under you, grounding down into the feet. One more. Inhale, expand out to the side ribs, the back ribs. Exhale to draw in from the abdominal core. Beautiful. And then still here standing, draw your shoulder blades down your back. We tend to keep them up very high by the ears. Just let them soften down by the back of your shoulders. It's imagining like a cape. So your shoulder blades are a cape that just rest on top of the shoulder rib cage. And I like to imagine that my cape is sort of drawing my sternum up a little bit while keeping the front ribs reaching down towards the hip bones. So there's a lot of this awareness in the thoracic spine and the shoulder girdle. And then lastly, we want to lengthen through the back of the neck, through the back of the head. And that creates lots of beautiful length and extension in the cervical spine. So we want to always be aware of our balance here in our spine. And I like to think of my hips, are my roots, and the spine is sort of lifting up from that space, from the sitting bones. And just feel your spine in space, in midair. And notice how your body's holding itself. Close your eyes if you're comfortable, if you feel safe and steady. Let your hands face forward and roll the thumbs out so you've got more opening through the front of your shoulders. Feel the ground under you. Everything is connected. Create more awareness of your breath as you inhale down into your hips, into the pelvic floor. Exhale, feel the lift from your pelvic floor up through your diaphragm. Inhale down and wide. Exhale, narrow the core. One more. Inhale down and wide. Exhale, narrow and lift from the pelvic floor. All right, now that we're nice and steady, let's do a little flow. Inhale, the arms reach up, palms come together. Exhale, hands to heart. Let the shoulders soften. Inhale, reach. Gather the energy up. Exhale, take it into the heart center. Again, inhale. Exhale. Open mouth exhales are really great if you need to release more tension or stress. So staying here, we're going to take a twist towards the right. Keep your hips facing the front. Don't mind the echoing. We're here in the Grand Canyon. There's a lot of echoing and cheering and whatnot. So it's wonderful to be here with you. Almost imagine what it would be like for you to be here with me. And then let's take our arms out wide. So we're creating this active twist through our core. And we're getting a lot of this in the thoracic spine, which is so great for creating more fluid, more space in the spine, in the spinal cord. All right, inhale, take your hands to your heart, come to center. Exhale, twist first before the arms go out to the left. Feel the hips are facing forward. So you're getting this, like, you know, opposition of the hip and the rib cage. And then inhale, the arms reach out. Feel that stretch through the pecs, opening through the heart. As you keep the hips facing forward, activate from your thoracic spine. Good. Inhale, come into center, hands to heart. Take one breath here. Inhale, take the arms overhead, palms open and facing each other. So we'll take a side stretch here over to the right. So right arm comes down, left arm over the ear. And this should come from the rib cage. Okay, we want to think about the hips moving, but we also really want to get this rib cage to curve, which is wonderful for opening up the vertebrae, especially from sitting. If you've been sitting today, this is a great way to create more space through your spine. Think about your shoulder socket, your upper shoulder socket, reaching up more towards the sky, and then notice you'll get a deeper stretch as you do that. More of a curve in the right side of the spine. Good. Inhale, center, arms up. Exhale, take the left arm down, stretch it to the left. Again, think about the ribs. We want to lift up from the shoulder socket here, up towards the sky to create a little more curve in the upper spine, up in the upper cervical spine as well. There's some curving there. And then keep the feet rooted down, really strong connection to the earth. It's always there to support you. And inhale, come on up to center. Now we'll do a little back bend. Bend the elbows like a cactus. And then lift the sternum. Maybe the gaze will lift up as well. So it's a very slight back bend. We're not really needing to drop back into a wheel or anything. We're lifting up from the core through the sternum and just broadening through the chest. Press the elbows back. Good. Feel the energy of the heart. Imagine if you could think with your heart. What is your heart telling you? Inhale to center. Take the arms in to together. Press the forearms together. And then from here, we're going to press the hands apart. So the elbows stay together, the hands come apart. We're getting more active in the external rotators. Good, so this is something that I like to do as a way to just fix shoulder pain, things like that. So external rotation here from the shoulders as you press the hands, good. So you know it's your external rotators when you can feel the back of the shoulders. One more breath here. Good. And then take the arms parallel, elbows bend back, and then squeeze your shoulder blades together so you're getting into your middle trapezius and your rhomboids, which is so good for posture, right? Again, if you've been sitting today, this is going to feel really nice. Get your spine nice and long, nice and lifted from your pelvic floor, from the sit bones, lifting up, connecting you into your deeper core. One breath here. Awesome. And then let's take the arms into eagle. So take the left arm under the right. Now your hands can come to the outer edges, or if you can go all the way to the inner edges of the hands, that's great too. If you are more tight in the shoulders, what you can do here is actually take the right arm out straight and get more into this stretch. Stretched into the back of the shoulders. That's what we're looking for. And then if that's what you're doing, then switch arms. And then everyone else, take the arms out. We're going to switch our eagle arms the other way. So right arm, or left arm actually. Right arm underneath the left. So again, hands to the outer edges, inner edges. or take one arm straight. And you can also add a little press of the hands if you want more sensation. So I'm getting into the stretch of the trapezius here, which should feel really nice. And the arms. One more breath. Okay, we're gonna take our legs into a position now. So let's start with warrior two. Your left foot forward, and then bend through the knee to bring the knee over your ankle. Back here a little bit. And then your back foot is 90 degrees. You've got your legs reaching in opposition. So press a little more into the back foot and bring the hips towards the front knee. Good. From here, we're going to take the back arm, bend the elbow. The other arm, you can hold a strap here, and you can take the strap into both hands.
Touch him.
Okay, if this is not accessible at the time, the back arm is just going to come to support the front elbow. Okay, but if you have a strap, this is great. So you can use a strap for this part. And so we've got a nice little stretch here in the front of the shoulder, the tricep, and then we've got our inner thigh stretching in the back leg as we go into a deeper lunge. Good. Stay for one more breath. And then straighten your front arm. Your back arm can come into a half bind, or you can rest that arm on the back leg. We're coming into reverse warrior. So we're pressing the hips towards the front knee as we find that side arc in the spine, which we did earlier with standing. So think about your front shoulder socket reaching up towards the sky, and then notice how that creates a deeper arc, a deeper curve. One more breath. Good. Inhale, straighten the front leg. Just take that arm forward, coming into triangle with a nice long spine, reaching through the front hand. And use your core strength. This is important. Use your core. All of this, the cylinder is wrapping around you, holding you, stabilizing you. One more breath here. Beautiful. Coming all the way up, we're going to just turn our feet to take warrior two on the other side. Come into your lunge by pressing into the back foot. Bring those hips towards the front knee. Get that beautiful stretch. Back inner thigh is deeply stretching. And then take the front arm, bending the elbow here. Again, your option is to use a strap to bring the hands behind your back, or you can take the back hand on top of your front elbow. And then just breathe here. You want to think about lengthening up from the sit bones through the crown of your head. Lengthen the back of your neck away from your sacrum. Think about the back of your spine being tall. One breath here. Inhale, the front arm reaches up. Back arm can half bind or rest. And then take that reverse warrior by side bending, lengthening from the front shoulder socket towards the sky. And then creating that deep lateral flexion. Again, this is so great for creating more spine extension or flexibility in your spine. One breath here. Inhale. Straighten the front leg as you reach forward so you can't reach anymore, and then stay. Think about rooting into the back foot, trying to pivot the front hip towards external rotation. So your right hip is rotating towards the right clockwise.
And think about the position of your ribs, getting your ribs really, really parallel. Imagine two planes of glass on both sides of you, kind of compressing you. Stay here for one more breath as you reach, like you're holding a teacup. Okay, inhale to come on up. Let's take Prasarita. So bring both feet pigeon toe, turning the toes in, the heels out wide. And then from here, your hands are going to clasp behind your back. Press your hands straight down into the ground so that your sternum can lift. Okay? And then from here, hook your hands onto your right hip. Good. And then you're going to drop your ear towards your right hip. So we're getting into a nice little neck stretch, which is one of my favorite things to do, is to stretch the neck. We hold a lot of tension, stress in the neck. It's also a source of our protection, so we tend to hover our shoulders up to protect ourselves. So our neck needs a break sometimes. All right, inhale, center. Take your hands to the other hip, hook around. And then also squeeze the elbows towards each other. And then drop your ear towards that hip. Just breathe slow and steady. Notice the feeling of the ground in your feet, the open sensation below your sit bones, the core activating above your sit bones internally towards the spine. Inhale, coming into center. Take the hands straight down towards the ground. Open up through the chest. Exhale to bow forward. Prasarita, Padottanasana, B. Or C. Good. And then at the bottom, take tiny little head circles. Relax your neck. Let your head hang like a piece of fruit, like a mango on the tree. Little head circles. Okay, and then circle the other way. Beautiful. Inhale, halfway lift. Take your hands to your heart in prayer, and then twist towards your right. Again, with the hands staying at the chest. We did this earlier, standing. So now we're doing it in a fold. Or more of a halfway lift, I should say. And you're using the core to hold you, to stabilize you, to twist you. See if you can draw that right shoulder up a little more. One more breath. Inhale, center. Exhale, twist to the left. Keep the sit bones reaching back, the crown of your head forward. And then find that twist coming from your upper spine. You might feel some work happening in the trapezius. Good. Take that left shoulder up a little more as you open the chest. Open the chest. Inhale to center. Beautiful work. Take your hands to your thighs and turn your feet out. Lift your chest. Arriving into goddess pose. This is goddess pose. Our toes are wide. Our heels are close. Good. And then take your hands to your heart. Good. And you can even take the arms out into cactus. And if you want to do the full version of goddess, lift the heels. And stay here. Feel this goddess energy. Goddess energy is divine feminine energy. It's all about your intuition. It's all about being in a nurturing place of being rather than doing. Masculine energy is about acting, moving, performing. And feminine energy is intuition, it's feeling, and it's stable. Very comforting, right? Energy. So feel that here. Imagine you're at the Grand Canyon. You're surrounded by these beautiful pink-orange rock formations that have been here for millions and millions of years. There's so much Gaia energy, right, for us to absorb. She is there when we're ready for her to absorb. One more breath in through. Exhale through the mouth.
Beautiful. Release the heels. Take the arms out to extended star pose. Exhale. Hands to the heart. Bring your feet close together. Coming back to standing. We'll end class with the sound of Om. The sound of awakening. The sound of the third eye. The intuition. So first exhale. Inhale. Thank you so much for joining me here at the Grand Canyon. This is beautiful. I love you all from my heart to yours. Namaste.